Hey guys, how's it going? That looks weird. Happy Friday. The reason I know it's Friday is because for the first time in, this is weird. Oh, I also just spilled water. That's why there's a spot right there. There's also like a crap ton of birds right outside my window, which is very cool, but wow. It's like I need to create a bird waiting room lobby. Anyway, the reason I'm bringing this up is a lot of you guys had asked me about some of the Reebok, I was about to call it bra top, sports bras. I don't really look at these. I have, okay, my view for people like me that have girls to lift up, when you're looking at a sports bra, there are sports bra tops, which is what I would call these. Okay, this is what's underneath this top. It's a Reebok sports bra, but I call it a top. If to me it's more like a tank top thing. I think someone's here. My mom's coming over any second, and I guarantee you, if she opens up that door, okay, she's probably not here yet. But when she does, the first thing she'll say, because my front door is like right that way, first thing she'll say when she walks in is, how do you know I'm not a stranger? It's going to come in because I just opened the door for her. She does that all the time. Anyway, if I call it a sports bra, to me, it's something that's like, it's got a hook, it's got some kind of underwire, it's more, I don't know, there's a difference. There's a difference in something that's more tank toppy and a specific bra. That's the way I do it. When you have a D cup, it's got to be a bra if you're going to go running, okay? Now, something like this, I would wear if I was doing a non-high-impact, non-plyo workout. And then this is my, just like a Reebok top on top of it. But I would say I've tried several of the Reebok bras. For me, I like this style. I would wear this for a workout. I would not wear this running. I don't think it's designed for running. It's actually from their CrossFit line. But this one has really good support. It's like whatever it's called in the back. But anyway, that's my view on it. And as I told you, it's very cool for me to be going down a size, not only in my tops, but also in my bottoms with Reebok. So anyway, happy Friday. And also the reason that I know it's Friday is because finally, this is my first day. I had a call scheduled at 9 o'clock this morning. I have nothing else on my calendar. So the first day in probably 4 weeks, I have nothing on my calendar. And I am taking a break today. My mom's coming over. We're gonna go to lunch. Mr. Flo. I did also, I wanted to tell you guys, if you saw my video with Caitlin the other day, she was telling me how she, for 2 months before she joined a CrossFit box, she did these traveling wads, and I'm like, what's the traveling wad? I went to the site, so it's fantastic. I have to connect with these people. It's a whole site dedicated to being able to do, if you're traveling, or maybe you don't have a CrossFit box yet, you can do CrossFit, you know, style workouts. I'm sure some douchebag out there would be like, that's not me, CrossFit workout. Whatever. Get out more. Start smiling instead of frowning and being bitter all the time. But anyway, they're CrossFit style workouts that you can do with little to no equipment. As if you were traveling, you obviously can't pack kettlebells and ultimate sandbags. Well, you can, sorry, I spoke too soon. You can pack your ultimate sandbag, because also I have to talk to Josh about that. He said that there's like, instead of sand, you could put water filling things in there. So in other words, you take it empty, fill it up with water in your hotel room, be able to use the sandbag. Gonna have to look into that. But anyway, I wanted to tell you guys that I did my first traveling wad. I don't know when it was, yesterday or the day before yesterday. Wow. Okay, so here's what I'm gonna tell you. This was, I should put a link up to it. It was two rounds of 15 of everything. And my core is killing me right now. I'm just gonna say that. There was this move, I'm trying to think of what it was, hollow something, where you're on your back. So think of the opposite of Superman's. You know, when you're doing Superman's, you're on your stomach and you have your arms up and you're kind of lifting up. Think of being on your back, but rounding out your back. Your legs are lifted off the floor like in a flutter kick, but so are your arms, and you're kind of rocking back and forth. Holy mother of God. So all I'm saying is I did that. I timed myself. I did it in 10 minutes. I'm sure I wasn't nearly as fast as I could have been. Still, I'm just going to tell you guys. And I just, who did I say it to? Oh, I had a meeting yesterday with a really great company, actually. I'll put the link up to that. They have all organic grass-fed, all grass-fed beef. Total wonderful food site for paleo people. Sorry, I'm like, what was I meaning to say there? But anyway, I was asking him, I said, is that a common thing when people start transitioning into CrossFit, is like not getting over that that was 10 minutes? I told you guys, that's been my challenge in the past, is that I overtrain. And I always think a workout has to be 2 hours. It's got to be an hour of cardio and an hour of weight training in order to be effective. So I will tell you, I'm sure, as much as I know, pretty much everybody that's been doing CrossFit and loves it, you can't look at the results and their physique and their strength and dispute it. I'm not saying that. It's just very strange. It's strange when you're used to things that last 45 minutes to an hour to look at something that is 10 minutes and I'm like, what do I do next? Now, when I was talking to Peter yesterday, he was saying, well, and his wife goes to the CrossFit box as well with him, and they were like, look, when you're at a box, you're there for an hour. So I'm sure they're stretching beforehand and after and all that. But anyway, I am excited. What I think I'm going to do, though, here's my plan. I'm home for three more days, then I leave on a trip for Atlanta. I get to Atlanta Wednesday, I'm not back till Sunday, then it's, you know, that holiday Monday. I think I'm going to do traveling WODs for 2 weeks with my other workouts. Then I will start, after I've done that for 2 weeks time period, then I will... then I'll make an appointment with my CrossFit gym, because my BFF, Austin Maliolo, so name dropping, aren't I? Told me, we looked when we were up in Boston at some CrossFit boxes, and he recommended ones that I should go to. Since a certain one, who I'm still gonna call and say, what's up with you not calling me back? Do you not check email? Yeah, I'm giving an attitude. So anyway. The water. Is it my hat that, there's like a funny smell. I'm very sensitive to smells. Anyway, it's Friday. It's lunchtime, and what is he gonna say? I forget what I was gonna say. But anyway, paleo is still going well. I will tell you this, the more I do it, the easier it is for me to, just in general, sorry, keep looking for my mom. It gets easier and easier for me to resist other things. Furthermore, here's another thing, that's what I wanted to bring up. The more that I have really cut certain things out of my diet, like I'm not doing even the littlest bit of dairy, earlier in the week, I don't know if I put this on my blog or not, I got a chicken gyro from the place up the street. You know, gyros, if you get them with the lamb, or even if you do the chicken, they come with that, however you pronounce it, tzatziki sauce, which is essentially, it's a sour cream base. I made the mistake. I got a chicken gyro, no bread, so I got it on lettuce with a bunch of tomato and onions, and then the tzatziki sauce was on the side. And actually, that sounds good. But anyway, they give you a really big portion, like it's that big. And so I had half of it the night before, and then the next day I went to have the second half. The next day I was taking my pieces of chicken, and I'm like, I'm just gonna have a little bit. Because, you know, I was thinking, like, other people are on paleo, and they have a little bit, so it can't hurt. They're doing something. That was not a good idea. Let's just say, I think that what's happening is, now that I've really, really cut out the dairy, when I go back, I need to stay broken up with dairy. I had the worst stomach ache that day, and the only thing I can attribute it to is the fact that the only thing I had different was dairy. I mean, that was the day, I don't know if I blogged about it, that was the day I went for my run, and I went kind of late, so it was getting dark, so I only had time, you know, I'm gonna need to look into when I'm out running outside, close where I don't blend in and get hit by cars. You see what I'm saying? I'm trying to be safe. So I went for my run. got a mile and a half out. Stomach ache was absolutely so bad, I literally could not run. I could really barely walk. And I'm a mile and a half out, and I'm like, I kept thinking the whole time, am I gonna make it home? Am I gonna throw up before I get home? Am I gonna be sick before? You know, that's like not a good feeling when you're that, not that it's that far. I'll just tell you, I was speed walking and not speed walking because of the, you know, aerobic benefits. I was speed walking because I'm like, get me to my house. Good times. Aren't you glad you had that visual of what I was going through? Anyway, I gotta go. I think I see my mom coming up. So we're gonna go have lunch. And then I'm gonna do my workout. And then I have a massage later. And then I'm going out. So it's gonna be a nice, somewhat, what normal people do on the weekends, kind of a day for me. And I'm very excited to hit Hotlanta next week. And that's that. I will also update you on other stuff later. But have a good weekend.